something brand new and something older to show you this time. We have pretty papers, and I will tell you, Heidi has had a wonderful time playing with these. So please, won't you come play with us? Now, before we get into the projects, I just want to walk you through the pretty papers. Now, this is an 8.5 by 11 collection. You get 16 papers. You're going to get two each of the ones I'm going to show you here. They are single-sided, by the way. So you can see there we have this one. We have an all-over green with a print. We have a black-brown with a pattern in it. And then we have the X's. We have a light pink. We have this with the blue and some very pretty flourishes on the corner. We have dots with flowers behind them in a bolder pink. And then we have another all-over pattern. So these are the eight. You're going to get two of each one. And yes, as always, on the back of the package, we do have a card for you, but I'm going to show that to you next. Now, let me bring this in. And you can see, we'll get in a bit closer. You can see the papers that were used are the X and that black brown, beautiful look. And we have paired this with some of the paper Tole. Now, this paper Tole is called Kindred Spirits. And like all paper Tole, they are die cut. They are also numbered. So if you want to layer them with foam tape, you can do that, and it's so easy to do. Let's talk about the foam tape. Now, my favorite, and the team's favorite, is our big roll, our jumbo roll of foam tape. Now, even though this is a giant roll, it is a thinner foam tape, and of course, it's double-sided adhesive. Now, for the times when you have teeny tiny pieces to put in, we recommend the foam squares. Now, these are 1/4 inch square. There are 144 on this sheet. And let me show you how this works. So on this sheet of Kindred Spirits, there are three finished designs. This one, and then the dove that we're going to look at right now. They're all die cut, as I said, and they all have numbers next to them. Right here, this is in a green, and there's 1, 2, 3, and 4. These are all in pink, and these are all in tan, so you know exactly what's going to go where. And what you do is you simply pop them out, just like this, and the first layer, we typically glue down, just like that. The second layer, we put some foam tape on the back of it, and then you position it over the matching art, just like this. So that's going to lift up some pieces. Now, the number three, same thing. Pop that out, put foam tape on the back, and this is where those foam squares really come in handy. And again, you're just lifting up some of the pieces. Now, I'm not taping these down, so they're moving a bit. Number four is this one, and that's going to go again on top of the matching art. And this is what you have when you're done. So it is very easy to do. And you can choose to layer them that way, or you could elect to use them individually, or just layer a couple of them, so whatever you like. Now, on this card, Heidi started with the brown and covered her card, and then did a smaller piece with the X's. She put some of the pink jewel borders, here it is, at the top and at the bottom. And then she put another strip of the brown along the center, and that really isolates this area, so those are really going to pop, and don't the colors just work perfectly together? Now, so she did layer her dove, as you can see. Then she decided to use the banner that was on that big flower, and she decided to isolate that and use that separately. Now, she did put the pink jewel dazzles, you know, these are the ones that have 540 on the sheet. She elected to put those, the eye for the dove, as well as in her flowers. There is usually extra art on the sheet, and so she added a piece there. A little bit of bow, a little bit of ribbon right there, the glimmer ribbon set. We don't see this very often, but it is a beautiful, beautiful look. Now, what's going to fit along that banner? Well, how about the tiny words and phrases? Now, this is the primary set. This has 6 sheets, and there are, let me see, 460 greetings on these sheets. So you can see what that does. Now, on the inside, oh, there isn't an inside. So this is what was done and in that Debbie did for us. So, and this is also on the packaging. Now, what else might you do? Well, let me show you Heidi's take on this. And we'll get in a bit closer so that you can see. And this is using that same Kindred Spirits paper toll. You can see this is the one. And she has done some fun things with this. So she took the cutting dies. This is the circle and has used it. Let me bring it here. So these are the circle and scallop. So she took her card and positioned the cutting die on top of it. So she did it just so that the die was on going over the fold on the card. That way it will still have a hinge. So you can see that she used the scallop. Now you do want to probably run it through your die cutting machine, maybe twice, just because you are going through 2 layers of cardstock. And Heidi has used our regular 5 by 6.5 inch cards, and because they're already for you. So she did that, and then she went back and die cut out of this paper, our first paper, and die cut 2 of the same scalloped, and then she glued 1 on the front of the card and glued 1 on the inside of the card. So that did a nice job. Now, what is this white, you might be asking? This is our snow suede paper. Now, if Sarah were here, she would be petting it because it really does kind of draw you that way. But the other thing about it, it's such a pure white that it just does a beautiful, beautiful job. And she die cut that out of the next size down of just the circle, glued it to the front, and then also glued 1 on the inside. Now you can see what she's done with the images that she has used. So she has just layered them. So there's 1, 2, 3 layers. This has the banner all together. Now I did just show you 2 cards that are each using the same thing. So, you know, what gives with that? Do you have to make a choice? Well, with the Money Saver, you don't, because the Money Saver, you're gonna get 2 of these. You're gonna get 2 of them for the price of 1, okay? Does that have you interested? Well, it should. So there's our dove and the banner, but here is our banner flower and then the dove on the inside. Now, what Heidi has added is back once again to the tiny words and phrases, and this is using the gold, and you can see you're the best. She's got some of the little hearts there on the inside. Life is good with that little flourish. Now I did find Heidi lives in Wisconsin, we are in Oregon, so her projects are mailed to me. And in that process, some of the dazzles kind of weren't as affixed as we really would like. So I did add a little bit of extra glue to them. So on the suede, that might be something you'd want to do. So get your glue stick out and just put the dazzle on it and it'll attach it and it works just fine. Now her bow comes from the ivory ribbon set. Looks kind of tan there, doesn't it? But it's in the ivory set. And that pearl, that comes from our rainbow flat back pearls. That's just a gorgeous set. You get a gazillion of them right there. So that is our second idea. Now we have more, because we have more things that we can do with those pretty papers. And here is one. This is using the pretty papers, but there's some other things. It's also using the botanical frames. And the paper that has been chosen is this one. So you can see how beautifully it's going to go with the botanical frames paper toll. And same idea. In this case, Heidi has elected to use her 5 by 6.5 inch card, but she cut it down to be 5 inches square. Okay. Then, starting from the bottom of our card, she took the paper and she cut a square to get glued straight down Then she went into vellum, and I love the combination of products that she has here. So here is the pink pretty paper. She also used our silver glitter cardstock that is non-shedding, our silver cardstock, it's so shiny, and vellum. So for the vellum, she tore it. Now, when you tear vellum, you don't want to fold it, you want to just tear it. So just like this, one direction, it's going to tear pretty straight. The other direction, it's going to be a little more wobbly because it has a grain to it, just like paper does. So that's all you're going to do is tear it to make a square, a smaller square, and she glued it at an angle. And again, you can just put the glue right into the center. Now, to build this piece, she punched out the number one of this square that has the butterfly, and she matted it on the silver cardstock with 1/8-inch borders, and then she matted again on the silver glitter cardstock, again with 8-inch borders, and then she foam taped it to the front of her card. How pretty is that? I like that offset vellum. It just does a nice job. Now, that's number one. Number two is this square, so she foam taped that. Number three is the butterfly, and she foam taped that in place. Now, she had some room and wanted to add a greeting, so back to the tiny words and phrases. Happy birthday fits just perfectly, as do so many of the other things. Now, to highlight her silver look, she added a bow from the gold and silver collection of ribbons, and that just does a really nice job. Now, inside, she took all of four of those elements, the paper, the vellum, the glitter, and the metallic cardstock, and cut or tore a piece that was 5 inches by about 1.5 inches, and then just glued them in layers on the inside, starting with the pink, then the vellum, then the glitter, and then the metallic. There is an extra piece of art. It always is labeled that way. You can see it right here. So she glued it, did another bow and zotted it. Make a wish from the tiny words and phrases right there. And just a very pretty and distinctive card. Again, in the Money Saver, and only in the Money Saver, you will get 2 sheets of the Botanical Frames paper Tole, 2 sheets for the price of one. And let's go now to our last card and look at this. Now, this is also using the pretty papers, of course, because we're really featuring that because that's brand new. But we have paper flowers to go with it. Now, the paper flowers have got 20 die cuts on it. And as you can see, they go from large to small so that you can layer them. And you can layer them to make 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 different flowers, or you could certainly make 10 different flowers if you just wanted a couple of layers on them. And here's a tip. You can even, these little samples, you can even cut those out if you wanted to get another look of layering your flowers and another piece of art. So you've got lots of options. Now, for this card, Heidi started again with the 5 by 6.5 inch card. Now, the bottom corner on the right, she measured up 1.25 inches, made a mark, and then drew a line to the opposite corner. That line she cut, and that became this flap on the card front, so you can see that. Now, she took the paper, and this is the darker pink, and that bright lime green, as well as our brown black, and she glued the brown black to the inside of her card to make a nice contrast. Now, for her first layer, she took the pink, put glue on that card front, positioned this, and then turned it over and trimmed it to fit. Then, to get her second layer, because it's a little tricky to do a shape like this, she put glue right here and cut her piece to go right here. The directions down are down below in the, just click on the card and you'll see it. So she made this shorter, did the glue, positioned this opened it up and trimmed it to fit. And that's how you easily get that shaped for the front of your card. Now, looking at these flowers, you can see that they are layered in two different ways. This one is layered so that the petals line up. This one, the petals are offset as she layered them. This is offset, and this is offset. So you've got options. Now, of course you have options. You always have options. Now, she also added some thin line glitter dazzles. You can see this, and I love how Heidi does this. It just adds a bit of design to an area that would have been a little bit plainer. So I love that. I like how she overlapped them. She did the same thing on the inside with the gold ones. On the outside, it's of course the pink. And this is from the thin line glitter set. So that worked out nicely. Now she also added her greeting. The more candles, the bigger the wish. These are from our card Inside Outside Dazzles. And it comes in multiple colors. And I think there are five sheets in this package. I have to look on the back where I have my notes. But you can see you get some little flowers. She did add the gold jewel dazzles to the center of her paper tole flowers, and it just makes a really nice look. So for today and for our money saver, we have our brand new Pretty Papers. Don't you like that name? That's going to have 16 sheets. And in the money saver, you will get two of the botanical flowers for the price of one. You will get two of the paper flowers for the price of one. And you will get two of the kindred spirits for the price of one, all together in today's money saver. And that money saver, you know where it is. It's on the right side of your screen. I want to thank you for joining us. I hope you're enjoying seeing something new paired with something a little bit older, but still gorgeous. All of them are gorgeous, and that's what we want. If you are watching this on YouTube, I hope you'll check that you like us and that you'll subscribe. We invite you to come to paperwishes.com and get all of the benefits, see the instructions, take advantage of the money saver, and become part of our Paper Wishes family. We'll see you next time.